Hey, good afternoon, Andrew and Roger. This is Sonny Martinez, of course. I wanted to go ahead and do a video on this house. I'm not going to recommend it, but I wanted to do it to keep in practice. And that way, it's a good idea to educate you guys on what you're going to start seeing and things like that this coming weekend and what I look for, things like that too, okay? All right, so this is the house in North Fletcher Hills. I kind of was interested in this because it has a pool. First of all, the color scheme is like, eh. You know, again, that's cosmetic. We could always change that. That's not a deal breaker. My only concern is the age of the roof. That looks like an old roof, and I can already see that some of the, like if you get closer, like you see a closer look up there too, they have what it's called, I think it's called fish hooking, where the wind pulls up some of the shingles and things like that too. But the good news on some of these houses, like I'm not a big fan of the brick, but there's no HOA, so you can paint it something like that over there. Like that off-white color is becoming very popular and contemporary around, you know, the homes like this, okay? So I'm going to walk it really quick. I'm going to put this on YouTube, of course, so you can see what I'm talking about. So I walked the perimeter and I checked out, you know, the brick and stuff, and the brick seems like it's in good shape. There are cosmetic issues like that. I think it's a lot of caulking. That's wood rot right there. So let's say we did an FHA thing, they would have to repair that. And the chances of a seller going to repair any of that kind of stuff are slim to none. I've had to repair it myself as a realtor, you know, because I want, you know, people to be in a good home. I've done house repairs too, but I see stuff like this, like holes underneath the slab right there. That tells me someone's or something's living in there, if you will. Okay, now here's where I start seeing problems right here. Yep, and I walked the house, and I'm going to show you why. Okay, if you'll notice the cracks right there, when you start seeing cracks in the brick right there, that means there's been some shifting. You will see cracks here in the mortar because sometimes it's they didn't mix it properly and stuff, but once you start seeing a crack right here, like through the bricks, that tells me there's a foundation issue in this house and has it been fixed, okay? Goodman is a good air conditioning. Of course, this one looks like it's aged, but I think it's because of all the algae on it too. That actually looks like it's a newer system. And of course, I always go around and check the date. Sometimes they have the date right here, okay? Again, yeah, I'm seeing a little crack. Little crack in the brick right here too. One brick crack, not too bad. When I see several, I go, ah, okay, that's an issue. We got rotted wood right here. So FHA would say you got to replace all that too, because that's that could be termites. I can't call it termites, but it could be. When I see rotted wood like that though, it's a problem. Also, that's a non-negotiable right here. Even if you're, that has to get fixed right there. See how that all that's pitted out? That looks like termite damage. That's why this house has been on the market. But anyway, I still want to do this video for you so that way you can see what I look for, things like that too. Nice layout, of course. Neighborhood, really gorgeous neighborhood. I have a couple of friends that live over here, and this is North Richmond Hill, so it's upscaling quite a bit, and great schools and everything like that too, okay? Let me give you a walkthrough right here. Oh, right here, I wanted to show you. That right there tells me that there was foundation issues, okay? And what they did was they put a pier. This is a slab house, but what they do is they put these big boulders, they jack it up and put a boulder underneath and lift up the house, and it stays. So it has had foundation work here on this outside. And all of a sudden you can tell, you know, some cracks there from when they did the work and they pushed up a little bit on the house too. The good news is I don't see a lot of cracked bricks on the front, so they probably caught it in time. But when I walked the house, I had to ask myself, was this pier and beam? So when I walk a house, like first of all, okay, you got this nice entry right here too, okay? It's kind of dated. You know, it's back in the day where they used to like, you know, blot, you know, this texture right here and then paint it. So, I mean, it's kind of dated, but the floors look great. But when I walk a house, I kind of do the scooting thing. Like I'm kind of skiing right here. And the reason why I do that is because I want to check and see if there's any pits. And right now I felt a big pit right here. There's a dip, okay? But as I started walking in the living room here, I can tell that the house is tilted towards this way over here. And especially in this room. Like I went to the master. The master's a nice size room. And of course, I'll slow down with the other house too if I see one that I actually like for you guys. I'm not a big fan of this one too. But when I walked this room right here, it felt like it was a roller coaster, like as I'm walking it too, because there's highs and lows in this flooring, okay? Like here's an example.
right there. Huge gap, right? Okay.
Yeah, that's a low spot in the floor. And what's frustrating about that is this is supposedly a slab. So there has been some excessive movement in this house. Okay, and that's why I have a feeling it's still on the market for X amount of days. And besides that, it's overpriced. But I'm really going to show you why it's been on the market. Okay, nice, I guess, you know, bathroom. In these homes that were around 1970s and older, you're going to see stuff like this too. This has been updated really nice. I mean, nice, you know, wow, nice countertops and, you know, everything's been updated, which is kind of cool. Yep, updated shower and stuff. Again, you know, excuse me going so fast in this house because it's not one that I'm going to recommend. How about that? But I just wanted to kind of, I like doing videos again because it keeps me, you know, active and in practice. Right here, another gap that tells me there's a low spot. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. See, as I'm walking the house, I can tell there's like many hills. Yeah, and for me, like I've done it long enough where I can go, okay, wow, there was a slight elevation or a dip right there, okay? So kind of a funky layout because, well, not really funky, but here's the dining area, which is kind of neat. Then it opens up in here to the living area. Now, if I were getting a house, I'd knock down that and that over there and open it up and it would be ginormous. You know, I can't believe I used that term. Anyway. And the reason why I would do that is because there's this area right here. I'm like, okay, I'm confused. What do you put here? A sitting room? A chair? So it's this little pocket of nothing right here. Wasted space. So that's why I would knock this down. But again, you know, how much money do you want to put into a house, you know, when you're paying X amount of dollars for it, right? Okay. Small kitchen, you know, some updates done on the appliances. You can tell it's small because the washer and dryer is right here. And of course it is hooked up for water. And let's see, I didn't go in the garage earlier. Yep, that's what I thought. Check this out. Now, this is not a deal breaker, but right here, look how wide that crack is. When it goes over a quarter of an inch, we recommend a structural person to come out and check it out, okay? And yeah, there's some wood rot right here too. This is why I'm not recommending this house. For the price that you're paying, now, I will say this, last year when the market was really hot, yeah, people were just throwing money. They would throw 50K over the asking price of a house like this. Right now that's starting to balance out, and now that the sellers are going through the winter part of real estate, and now it's the buyer's summer part, we can be a little bit picky. Again, houses in this age group, though, you are going to have to do some cosmetic things, okay? But here's the reason why I'm not recommending this house, for one thing, because this would be costly. Yes, it has a pool in it, but I'm evaluating as I walked it. And check that out. I don't know if you can see it. That line right there has algae all down it. That means there's a huge crack in the pool. Okay, I don't know what went on here, but it cracked all the way here, all the way around. Yeah, there's been some major shifting right here. And then, I don't know if you can see that. I'll try to lower my phone to where you can see it. But right here on this edge of the pool, lots of damage and a huge crack. Yeah, so this pool would have to be all redone. They might have to even, yeah, it would be thousands just to repair the pool to how you want it. They don't recommend doing a liner to cover that stuff up because what happens is those cracks will get bigger and bigger and it's going to cause more problems too, okay? The funny thing about it is I didn't see a lot of cracks. Well, the only one I see right here, and this is common, you know, around pools. I see one crack here. Oh, now I see another one. Okay, just two so far. Usually, I would see more cracks, you know, surrounding the pool in a situation like this, but as you can tell, there's a lot of pulling apart right here. So there has been a lot of ground shifting. Yeah, and the pool's filled with algae, so they haven't taken care of it. But the main concern I had was that big crack in the bottom too, okay? All right, the good news on this house is, I mean, it's a nice yard and you could do a lot with it. And there's a huge, you know, slab right there. You could do entertainment, you know, and have major parties here and people outside and stuff like that too. But again, as I'm looking at the roof, like I can tell that roof has got to be over 10 years old. And my inspector's gonna go, you need a roof specialist to come out and take a look at it. And the roof specialist is gonna go, that needs to be replaced because there's a lot of this, this, this. I can already tell, okay? I look for stuff like this too, right there. So rest assured, I look for that kind of stuff because you guys are gonna be more concerned about, you know, room size, you know, and things like that. I'll take care of the details, you know, like this kind of stuff right here. See that gap right there? Guess what happens? Bugs, everything gets in there too. That's not a deal breaker, but I would insist on the seller, hey, we need to fill that up right there too, or fix this board. You know, 9 times out of 10, a greedy seller is gonna go, no, we won't do it. Ah, here, check this out. Look at this line right here, this crack all the way down here. Again, yeah, major foundation issues. Yep, check this out. See, that's the kind of crack I was saying that might be okay and doesn't mean that there's a foundation issue because it's the mortar. But then once you start getting this right here, and then you start getting an inkling of this, and that's starting to crack, you got something here, that's where I have a sensation of there's been some shifting in this house and we'll need a structural person to do it. Now, does having a foundation issue mean that it's a deal breaker? No. In Texas, it's not a matter of if you have a foundation problem, it's a matter of when you have one. Most likely you will have one. Now, it's not a scary thing. I had a house where we had it on the market and a structural guy came out there and said, yeah, there's needs to have, you know, 9 piers around. And it's like that hole, you know, that hole I showed you in the porch. Well, imagine 9 of those around the house to get it balanced again. And that was $1,200. And I've been told that pier and beam was cheaper than slab. That's actually incorrect. Pier and beam is more, can be more expensive than slab. Okay, slab is a matter of digging a hole, lifting it up on one side, it pushes the other side down or whatever they do to balance it. And they do a whole, you know, computerized thing. They check the plumbing and everything that's involved with it too. So, you know, foundation things do not scare me. However, for the price of this house, and most likely since he hasn't changed his mind on the pricing, he's probably not going to pay for a structural engineer guy to come out here and evaluate it. And it's roughly about $600 to $800. But I would demand that, you know, if you were totally in love with this house, okay? Or they come down on the price and we pay for it, okay? Like, check out that big crack right there, too. Look at that. That's separating from the house. Yeah, so this is a no-go for me. You know, I'm sure a no-go for you, too. So, anyway, I hope you like this video. Once again, it gives me a chance to keep in practice of what I do and what I look for, too. But again, I want you to know that when we go shopping around, that you guys can focus on, I like this space, this works for us, and I can focus on the details, catching all the stuff. You know, again, will a seller, you know, repair something like this? Probably not, but I know some people in that can fix cosmetics like nothing, and they can fix that for you. All they got to do is sand it down, put some wood filler, and repaint it. And that's a brand new post again, okay? Now, if it's to the point where it's disintegrating, you know, and I can do this and it starts like breaking off, yeah, that's a problem. But that's just due to water, you know, right there. That's just sanding and painting and getting that going. And if you had to buy a post like this at, you know, Home Depot, maybe about $50, you know, and it just takes, you know, putting another post right here, you know, and holding it up, knocking this one out, putting it in place, and then, yeah, it's really easy to do. I can even show you how to do that. That's very easy. This was also attachment too. Yeah. So I wish they would have painted it. It would have keep it from rotting, but that's plywood right there. So I wish they would have done that. Okay. So anyway, yeah, this is a no-go for me, but I just wanted to do a video for you so you can see what I look for and you guys can focus on the other things. All right. Talk soon.